Hello, my name is Monica Little, and I'm an application engineer at Keysight Technologies. I'm here today to present Harmonics feature of IntegraVision power analyzer. The way I'm going to find out Harmonics, I have connected this DC-AC inverter, and I'm looking at the output of this inverter, which is, this is the voltage what is giving out. It's obviously pretty chopped and rectangular, so I'm expecting quite a bit of harmonic distortion here. So all I need to do now is to push button analyze, and from the menu I pick harmonics, and quickly I can evaluate that my harmonic distortion on a voltage is about 28%. At the same time, I can observe the signal itself in time domain. I also see DFT on the purple line, and I have the values of the each harmonics in the table. Now, if I want to go deeper into analysis, I have a few options here. I can add the bar chart, which is in a logarithmic scale. Another thing I may want to do is to go to measure and find out that my frequency actual, it's a little bit different. It's not exactly 60 hertz, it's 60.05. So now I can go back to this menu and enter the fundamental frequency closer, which will give me a more precise reading. Another way to enhance the accuracy of the reading is to change the how long the period is of collecting data, because we are collecting data in CWA mode, which is the continuous whole cycle analysis, and we can decide how long period I want to collect data. I will pick 2 seconds just to not make it too long, but obviously that will increase accuracy of the measurement again. Now, as default, it's set to 40 harmonics, but I can go for line frequency as high as 250, which obviously will give me again more precise reading. Now it seems like I have about 29% of distortion. Last not least things what I want to show is very unique feature what we have here. I could play a little longer and with trigger settings. I already found before that this switching frequency of this inverter is 440 hertz. So now I can go and actually enter those 440 hertz as fundamental, and that way I can find out how much harmonic distortion is caused by this switching frequency. Even without having this signal brought to the any input, I can find this information. So this was a quick overview. Thank you very much for your attention.